So Disney's top brass, they had to nix those bonuses, and they had to take salary cuts for 2020, and they act like they're living like the rest of us plebs. In fact, over the last year, we've seen these people backpatting themselves, acting like they've given up something major, acting like they're suffering along with the rest of us, and now we have the details of their 2020 compensation, and yeah, this is insulting and beyond. Remember, these are the heads of a company that in some states, they laid off tens of thousands of workers. Overall, we're talking about hundreds of thousands of people that went without for months. You see their employees standing in bread lines. They're wondering where they're going to get their rent from. They're wondering where they're going to get health care from, how they're going to feed their children. But yeah, these people, they act like they've been doing without. And when you see exactly what they brought in, oh man, it is time for some changes. So hey there, folks, by the way, I hope that your afternoon is going splendid. And you're going to have to forgive me for this video. Not only is it going to be a little bit snarkier, but yeah, you can tell how I feel about people like this, about elitists here, and especially ones that pretend that they're just like us. In fact, let me put this out there before we really get started. If you find yourself doing without basic necessities, we're talking about canned goods, talking about diapers, formula, and on, hit me up. I cannot give you money. I want to stress that, but we'll try to find you some way of doing something about that, because you know what, from my family to your family, I want to say I appreciate you, and you know, we're all in this together. You and I, we're the ones that are going to have to work this out, because these folks, yeah, you've seen exactly what they do, and it's a whole lot of nothing. So anyway, back to our article here. Disney nixes bonuses for top executives as it details its 2020 compensation. Now, the two people that they're talking about here, it's the two Bobs. We're talking about Bob Chapek. That's the new designated CEO. He took over in late February. And we're talking about Bob Iger. Now, as they tell you, it's been a very unusual year. The first in which Chapek led the company, and with nearly every part of Disney's business impacted by, well, you know what. The company said that in light of the company's circumstances this year, all of its top executives, they would end up foregoing their bonuses. Man, what a tough life there. In addition to the salary cuts they announced last summer. Now, Chapek, who was elevated to CEO role in late February, has been with the company since 1993 and previously worked as chairman of Disney Parks, Experiences, and Products since 2018. Now look at his compensation here. His compensation package for the most recent fiscal year. So we're talking about 1 year here. We're not talking about a bunch of time together. We're talking about 1 year here. It totaled $14.1 million, reflecting the challenges of everything going on, and an overall pay package that's smaller than Iger. What exactly are we talking about here, too? Reflecting the challenges of the beer bug. Again, they act like this man is doing without. He has a fiscal year, 1 year, in which he makes $14.1 million, and they act like they're standing in the bread line with you. Like I said, it's beyond insulting. Then we get to Bob Iger. Again, Bob Iger has been one of those talking heads that's been out there. Again, acting like it's all of us in it together, you know, like he's suffering along. Well, Bob Iger's compensation for the most recent fiscal year amounted to $21 million. He brought in 21 million freaking bucks, but compared to the last few years, man, that's apparently chump change. Look at these totals here, too, and think about how bad poor Bob is hurting. I mean, compared with $47.5 million per previous fiscal year, so we're talking about 2019, the man made $47.5 million and $65.6 million in fiscal year 2018, which was boosted by a stock package that Iger was awarded as incentive to remain with the company past his originally planned retirement date. I mean, we're talking about 3 years here, in which a person brings in around $130 million. But again, you know, these folks here, they pretend that they're just like you. And beyond that, this is a guy with political aspirations. He's basically amassed a small fortune, but he pretends like he's right here, like he's in touch with everyone else. Man, this stuff, I tell you, when I look at this, it again, it just irritates me. So Disney disclosed top executives compensation in a regulatory filing with Securities and Exchange Commission. All the company's top executives saw their compensation decline significantly compared to the year prior. In a letter to shareholders, Disney's Compensation Committee wrote that in the company's 2020 compensation plan was, quote, made to motivate executives and recognize them for their unwavering efforts and leadership through the beer bug, while taking into account the beer bug's impact on the financial performance of the company and the broader employee workforce. You notice that they throw that in there, too. Well, you know, we want to think about how this impacted the company overall. And yeah, you know, the plebs out there, the people that it drove to homelessness and beyond, we need to think about them, too. So, of course, we're going to have to cut down the $47 million to $21 million and give that other guy only $14 million. What chump change. But continuing, the committee considered this backdrop in determining compensation for the company's executives, including taking action to meaningfully reduce NEO compensation and further incorporating ESG metrics for diversity inclusion. Diversity and inclusion, indeed. You know what we need to be looking at? We need to be looking at the haves and the have-nots. But yeah, these people, they learn how to divide us and pretend they're doing something good. But anyway, I digress. Into executives go forward compensation structures. Now, they talk about them taking pay cuts, and you know, that was discussed at one time. Again, they made a big deal out of it too, because you know, we're all in this together. Now, I want to skip forward to this little backpat here. Why? Because this, oh man, again, it sets my teeth on edge. Remember, this is in the backdrop of a company losing $7 billion. This is in a backdrop of laying off some 32,000 direct employees. When we talk about indirect employees, you're talking tens of thousands more people. To give you an example of what I mean, say you go into a theme park, say you want to get food. Yeah, those businesses there, they're not owned by Disney, but many of them shuttered. They will never come back. All of those employees there, they're laid off too. But hey, you know, quote, as CEO, enduring one of the most challenging environments the company has faced, Mr. Chapek adeptly managed the enormous disruption the company's business, while at the same time restructuring Disney's media and entertainment business to fuel the long-term creative and financial growth of the company, the Compensation Committee wrote in its letter. For his part, Mr. Iger did a tremendous job of overseeing the creative output of the company to help fuel the successful launch of Disney Plus and to position our DTC platforms for future success. So yeah, you have them acting like all of this stuff going on, that's just a little hiccup. That's just a little bit of a bump. Again, tens of thousands of people losing their jobs. Well, we still need to give that one guy $14 million. We still need to give that other guy $20 plus million. And yeah, we have tens of millions of dollars going to other people too. But again, you know, that's just all in it because they're just like you. They're just like you indeed. But anyway, let me know what you think about this in comments. And as always, I want to say this sincerely. I do appreciate the heck out of you folks. You make this stuff work. We couldn't do it without you, so thank you. These companies, they forgot it. Woe be it unto them. That's why we have these new platforms, baby. But anyway, let me know what you think. And if you want to help out the channel, there are links in the description. We could always use your help. We have a bunch of links there, including our comic book. Our comic book, it closes out at the beginning of February. We start printing and shipping. So yeah, get in there before it's done. And thank you. I do appreciate you as always, and we'll see you soon.